We're actually able to finish the main story of the game right now. There's the Black Garden, the final mission of the original Destiny campaign. But that's, where's the fun in that? Look, there's a whole strike over here. There's two missions down here. Back on Venus, there's a strike over here. There's the House of Wolves mission here. There's another thing down here. See, he has more things to do. Let's go visit this archive before we do that. Even though it's gonna be weirdly low level. I'd rather finish all the other missions first than finishing the Black Garden early and then being like, I guess we'll go wrap up other missions now, even though the story's over. That seems like I feel like the Black Garden's gonna be the best thing for us to do for a finale.
We just got this, on a secure channel from the Krypton.
The Ishtar Collective gathered some of the greatest minds of the Golden Age. Their archive is a treasure of knowledge that we cannot lose to the Fallen. Secure the archive, and the Cryptarchs will be in your debt.
The archive is buried under the rubble of the Academy. It won't take the Fallen long to strip it like the rest of the planet. We better find it before they get inside.
Enter the Academy.
Here we go. Oh. Anticlimactic a little bit, just to randomly collide with something like that. It's because I'm such a pro, if you hadn't picked up on that. Oh. Man, now we're going to be firmly in Witcher territory, where it's like, well, I could just go wrap everything up, or I could go run around and check out all the cool shit that I haven't quite done yet. Whee! I will say that this is the type of mission I would have done sooner before. Normally, I would just do ascending order by level, but the game keeps giving me quests, so I'm keep going like, oh yeah, we'll go where the next quest tells me to go. But somewhat strangely, the game kinda doesn't tell you to go everywhere with the quests. They leave a lot of areas optional, which, you know, makes sense. That is how RPGs usually work, but it's a little bit of a surprise to me, because if you only do the main campaign, this is a pretty short game. A lot of the stuff I've already done was optional. Whee! Oh. Down we go. So we're back in this open area. Hey, we didn't see a lot of this place since then, huh? Wait, we haven't seen this place at all. Really, have we? Oh yeah, I came here on accident that one time, and I was like, this is a place where the... I almost said the Geth. This is where the Vex fight against the Fallen for a while. And then I don't think I ever had to come here again. I think this entire area is actually optional to the story. Interesting. But we're gonna have some fun. Hey, buddy. Bye. 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 Said in sync. Is there a... It's probably a chest up here, right? No? I think that's one of the random ones, not one of the golden ones. I think I've actually exhausted a lot of my knowledge about golden chests at this point, I think. I think I've been to a lot of the ones I already knew how to find. I think I have to... Didn't I find three last episode, or the episode before? In the same session? Some of them are just packed. Hello, Hall of Whispers.
Great. The Fallen have already set up shop here. Let's hope they haven't gotten into the archive.
Hey, buddy. I'm fairly familiar with this mission because the game likes to throw this to you, at least in Vanilla Destiny, it likes to throw it to you as being one of those like, do this as a level 28 or 26 mission or whatever. So you have to do it at a pretty high level difficulty with some modifiers in it. The modifiers are basically the same thing as the skulls from Halo, I believe, 3 and on? Or was it Reach and on? Where you basically increase your rewards, but you also add special modifiers to the difficulty besides just the usual thing of like, they're harder. Die. Halo would do stuff like, here's the difficulty where you don't respawn when you die and you have to start the whole thing over. Or here's the one where you don't have a HUD. Or here's the one where people drop less ammo and stuff like that. And that's kind of what happens in this. There's a series of rotating modifiers that they'll throw at you when you play on the heroic versions of missions. Oh, get out of here. One of them, the most common, I think the mandatory one that's on it all the time, at least back then, was I think it was called Juggle or something like that. Basically, no matter who you were, no matter what you did, whatever gun you used would be the ammo, that type of ammo would not drop from guys you killed. Which meant that you were constantly running out of ammo on the one you were using, and the other guns, your primary, secondary, heavy, that's what I mean by type of gun, those guns would be getting ammo, while the one you're currently holding in your hands was not getting ammo. So it forced you to switch between your weapons over and over again. Just cycling through your three a lot, which is actually a pretty fun way to do things. It also meant that if you're in a boss fight and you had a specific weapon you're trying to use against the boss, you'd very specifically not use that weapon to clear the trash around the boss, because killing those guys with your other weapon would increase the chances of dropping ammo for the weapon you're trying to use. That guy just disappeared. Oh right, once you kill enough dudes, they kind of tend to give up and vanish at that point. Any side? Those are all sealed. Or they're all darkness anyway.
That's it. The archive. Secrets of the Golden Age, untouched for centuries. Radio A encryption. They were serious about keeping people out. Not a problem.
I'm sure it's not a problem, Ghosty. I believe in you. Nolan Bot, is there a chest back here? Nope. I'm pretty sure there's a chest somewhere in this game that's hidden behind a desk like that, but there's a lot of desks in this game. So this is a cool little encounter. The Hall of Whispers feels a lot like... what are they called? I actually can't remember what they're called in a Halo ODST and on, they started having...
Unbelievable. The Archive's power is still partially activated.
They had some kind of wave-based survival mode. The common parlance at this point has become just calling it a horde mode, but the one in ODST and on strike team, I don't know. But this whole level that I'm about to enter feels a lot like
Welcome,
one of those
Dr.
maps.
Shin. Please enter your security clearance code.
Dr. Shim? Never mind that. Let's hit that terminal up ahead. This place is amazing. It's bigger than the archives in Old Accra.
Thank you, Dr. Shin. Shall I begin correlation of Vex Mind core samples?
So polite. Well, let's see what they've got.
Dr. Shin, security breach detected. Intruders, initiate Protocol 19.
Well, let's get ready.
They followed us in.
Hey guys, where you at? Oh, were you what was that? Oh, I thought I saw an invisible one. Just these guys. Hey guys. Hey, wait your turn. Oh, there you are. I was like, where'd he go? Well, I unlocked an upgrade, that's nice. Is it for hard light? It sure is. Glass half full, the bottom half of each magazine causes additional damage. That's an interesting modifier, because it disincentivizes the primary way that I play, basically. I will shoot one guy, and then if there's no more guys on the screen, I'll usually hit the reload button. But that... making the bottom half of each mag do more damage very specifically disincentivizes that, because it means you don't want to reload reflexively, you want to reload when you're actually out of ammo. It also increases the risk, sort of a risk-reward thing, because you're increasing the risk of the situation of, like, you being having to reload in the middle of a gunfight because you were trying to milk out the extra damage. Like that. There we go. That's the solution for that problem. But yeah, playing this in the hardest difficulty, even with a group, can actually be really goddamn hard. It's a really cool level.
Remote hub failure. Routing disrupted.
They must have a server they're feeding off the power.
They created a really good Halo-style, like, multiple floor interior location, and then set up multiple waves to attack you with varying enemy types. Like, we'll start getting invisible waves, like that guy that just showed up. So it feels so much like... is it a fire team? Is that what they called it? I don't know. Bye! Feels so much like that kind of level. There's the invisible guys. They're sort of camping out back here. Hoop! Did I not kill them all the way? Where's the last one? Is he here? Maybe not.
I made a mess here, but I got this. They're tapping in somewhere else.
Yeah, this location has a lot of the makings of a Halo multiplayer map. The only problem is it's too open. It's roughly like half of a multiplayer map, basically. Hey, Servitor, I'm gonna ruin you. After I ruin your friends. How's that feel? I just
punched the globe until it exploded.
Ghost, deploy! They're coming.
I'll have it back together quick. They're still falling in here.
There's me ignoring the incentive and reloading anyway. Where y'all at, Fallen? Where you guys at? Huh? Down here? Down here being noisy? No one likes noisy. Actually, a lot of people like noisy. Hiccups, why? Yeah. Hey, buddy. There we go. You'll get along great with my gun. Hey. Hey. Hey, hey, wait your turn, everyone. Do not appreciate. Oh, you're not reloaded at all. You get, damn it, reload, you gave away the surprise. Hey, buddies, I'm coming for you. Come here. Punchy, punchy. You threw a grenade at me. Shame on you. Where you at? Where you at, buddies? Oh, there you are. You're trying to be stealthy, huh? Oh, he actually vanished.
Let's get back to the archive.
Oftentimes, the last guy in a wave will disappear because they probably don't want to deal with players having to hunt for the last guy that's just standing somewhere on the map. So the last few people will sometimes vanish when you've taken everyone out in these more weird locations where you could actually lose track of them.
This archive is amazing. Pathways to other galaxies, mappings of a Vex underworld, a place they called the Vault of Glass. Hopefully the Cryptarch can make sense of it. I'll let him know we found it.
The Vault of Glass. The first raid of this game. Six players required, or it's supposed to be six players required. You normally need like six players to get through the door at least. And then genuine, full-blown, like, raid bosses in a way that you would not expect from the game that you've seen so far. Alright, now. A Kell Rising, the next House of Wolves mission. Level 16 story. Head off the House of Wolves and Venus before their Kell, Skolas, can wrest control of the House of Winter.
Guardian, I can't wait to work with you. Been a long time since I was in the field, even if it's just on the comms. The wolves are led by Skolas, the last of their Kells. He wants control of another fallen house, the House of Winter. He'll kill their leaders and take command of their troops. With your help, we'll stop him cold.
Your ghost is feeding me telemetry. I see what he sees. Why not take one of those heavy pikes for a spin?
Fun times. Look.
Those heavy pikes come standard with mines. Not sure how to deploy them, though.
Oh yeah, there's fun to be had with this. So we have actual cannons, and then we have a dodge that also shoots missiles around. On top of having the ability to sort of dash around a bit. Up we go! Ooh. Cleared. Hey guys, I don't wanna alarm you, but you might be kinda boned, cause look at this thing. Look at this thing, why weren't you in this thing? Whee! I just lost my internet connection. Sweet. Alright, well that didn't go great, but let's try this again. I love reloading the entire game. I think my network went down briefly or something. I don't know, that was weird.
The wolves have control of the House of Winter's artillery. Take it out before they dig in.
They got a tank. We're going to see a spider tank on Venus now, instead of them being exclusively on Earth. And he's going down, aim for that head. There we go. Put some nice dents in that hit points. Oh, he's persisting. Hip. Quick dodge. Ooh, he's coming at me. Oh, hey guys, how you doing? So, you guys could just step aside for a moment. We're kind of doing a thing with, you know, the big boys are fighting. Fine, I'll clear out the dregs real quick. Get out of here. Shoo. Oh, I leveled up again? I'm not even trying to level up. I'm already too high. I'm actively trying not to level up by not picking up any bounties anymore. Hey, guys. Are you all just here to be dicks? Oh, don't knock me over. You're being rude. I just bought this thing from the curb where I stole it. Die? They're coming in waves, wow. I wonder if they're supposed to spawn in as the thing loses health, and it lost health too fast, and they're coming in like too many waves now or something? I don't know. Might be overreading into that. Blow up some mines! Don't know if it's more efficient to shoot mines or bullets, but it's about to go down. There we go.
Last week I was delivering court messages. Today we're delivering explosions. I love field work. Get after them, Guardian.
She's having fun. She's having fun indeed. Right, where can I go from here? Hello, Ramp.
The House of Winter and Devils and Kings, they hate Skolas. They think he betrayed the Fallen at the Twilight Gap. Your ghost is detecting traces of a stasis field. Skolas was in a pod for years. It might be him.
You can't stop me. You can't tell me I can't have it anymore. Come on. Come on. Yeah! Fuck your shit. You can't stop me from taking this thing in here. I'll take this thing wherever I want. Enjoy my bouncy mines, asshole. I don't think I'm supposed to have this up here. And I'm okay with that.
Strange. They should be fighting. If the House of Winter already kneels to Skolas.
Die! Skolas, you're gonna get wrecked! Beat him!
Barrix, get on the comms! What did he say?
Yes, yes. In your tongue, he said. The wolves stand strong, cower before the Kell of Kells.
Kell of Kells? Did he give himself a promotion?
A fallen legend. He sees himself as a prophet, perhaps. Or he has gone quite mad.
So we're playing, as you can tell, we're playing through a zone backwards. So there's a strike that I'm gonna play later that takes me through that door. And where we start off this area the way we did before, and it takes me through that door. So I basically just played that strike backwards and came this way through. So here's that whole cliff we took to get to that ship. That was last episode, I think. So you guys remember that, fresh off your head. But now we're going up the cliff instead of down it. This is part of my ongoing disappointment with the first two DLC packs for this games, because it's a $60 game, $35 expansion pass to get the two expansions, and most of the expansion missions are stuff like this, where it's like, hey, you know that mission we already did? Play it backwards. It's like, you guys didn't even make new stuff for us. Oh, I died. I'm dead. I died. Okay, that happened. That was interesting. Oh, right! When we're messing around in co-op, we actually brought our ships up here. Yeah, we did the same trick where we brought the ships up here, and you just magically die. This just happens. It seems to happen if you fly that ship up here, is it just like, it just finally just kills you off for having it. It's really strange. It doesn't even give you like the respawn button prompt, so you're like, what's happening right now? Hey, buddy. A tracer? Ew, I don't want that. You guys can stay where you are. Are those things supposed to mark me? Let's keep an eye out. Hey, buddy. Oh, what are those? Oh, they're slow-mo bubbles. I don't like that. They got me. There we go. Where are you at? There's one over here shooting me somewhere. I don't know what that is. Ruin them all! Chica! There we go. But yeah, They charged $35 or $40 if you didn't get this pass and you bought the two individually. Which I guess you'd only do if you bought the first one without buying the pass or something. And so that's like 66% of the original game's price charged all over again. And in stuff like this where it's like, hey, that's the same location, but backwards. I don't know if that's really worth the money, as it turns out. Oh well, I'm over it. I'm over it.
We're getting close. That cryo trace is getting stronger.
I'm a little less bothered because I did spend a lot of time with the main Destiny game before any of the expansions come out. And I did buy... when I finally did buy the expansion pass, it was on sale.
That's the Kell. Take him down, Guardian.
I got this. Lulz. You need a better plan. Oh, he's leaving me. No! But I was destroying him.
And he's gone. That skiff has already broken orbit. No problem, Guardian. We'll get him. There's still plenty of wolves in there. Best clear them out. Impressive weaponry. Ferex, what is that thing?
Scorch cannon. Powerful and very rare indeed.
Ow, ow. Rude. Oh, they're way down there. That's hard to shoot. But yeah, say hello to the location where we got that golden chest last time, right over on that cliff. Ow! Okay, fine, I'll come down. You clearly have the line of sight advantage here. What's this thing? It's all glowy. Is it a servitor or a Death Star? Oh, now they're coming closer. You're coming into my range. Take out them tracers. Where you at? Eh? Throw it? That's a bad throw. That was a bad throw on my part. They're closing in. You guys are just entering my range, is what you guys are doing. Yeah. Hey, buddy. Oh, you got a lot of hit points. I'll fix that real quick. I have the high ground. They want me to go down there to play with the toy they gave me, but I'm up here. I have such a clear line of sight advantage. All right. Well, that guy's gonna take an annoyingly long time to kill. Let's play with our new toy. Hey, buddy. Fuck you. I got a Scorch Cannon. Bam. Are you scared yet? I've actually never gotten to play with this before. This is new for me. This was not on the main game. So this is new, at least. That gave me our third-person rocket launcher. Oh, and it's gone. Goodbye, new toy, forever. Hello. Oh. You hitting me with something? Oh, missed him. Good job, me. Where are you hiding? I see you. And now I don't. And no one ever will again. I won't tell your family. They're just gonna always wonder what happened to you. Oh, that guy got past me. Tracers everywhere. Let's just throw something in that general direction. That'll probably interrupt some of them. Hey, buddy. Oh, how'd you get behind me? Oh, they explode? Those are explodey ones. I don't like that. Any more? That green one was wired to explode. Oh, Servitor, why? Why must you cause me pain? Okay, bad stuff's happening all around me. Let's blow things up. That is the correct time to use that power. Hey. 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 Hi, Servitor. Wanna just take a little break from being alone? Oh, that's anticlimactic. I was literally two bullets away from dying. Way to go, me. King of the professionals. Hey, guy. Oh, that's a lot of things in one hallway. Let's just shoot all of it. Here we go. Oh, you're not dead yet. You guys aren't done? You sure? What if I throw a grenade in there? You guys done yet? Oh. Nope, they're still persisting a little bit. Oh, there's a big guy. No one told me there'd be a big guy. And no one has to tell me because he's gone. Servitor. Oh. Wow, there's a lot of bad guys around here. Dear Lord. You guys come to me. You guys come over here. I got a new home. It's mine. Oh, sir, I'm supercharged. Hey, guys. Alright, well, I know what to do about this. Hit. Boom. And then he was erased. The end. Scorch Cannon. Boom. Boom. This is just fun to have. Oh, look at me leveling something up. There must have been a solar weapon bounty that I've had for like the last 5 episodes because I haven't picked up any new bounties for a long time. Where you at, bad guy? There we go.
That's strange. For a moment, I detected Vex energy all around the site. As for you, that was great work. Nice to meet a guardian that exceeds my expectations. Come back to the reef. Winter now bows to Skolas, and the wolves have just gotten started.
You're goddamn right.
Now we're back in the reef. Wow, you can really see how shiny my equipment is in this environment. Hang on a second. Got some loot along the way. I am going to want to identify some of these 122, so don't want to really bother with this necessarily. Over here, 115, same situation. Should identify these things before I invest in upgrades, though. 110, alright. 115 is higher. What am I getting to change to? Sort of a sash thing. Alright, it matches just as well as the other one. Went from a nice purple to a nice green, but they both match the colors also on my character, at least. These things are noticeably worse. I have quite the good ghost shell, apparently. So don't have to worry about that getting replaced anytime soon. What's this down here? Shotgun, fusion, sniper. Different elements. I have other elements both represented, so it's not that big of a deal. They seem to have otherwise the same stats. Arbitrarily getting rid of one. Another sniper. Same decision again. Other equipment? Not really. Let's go get our stuff identified then. Then we'll find out whether or not something else is an upgrade. I like how this character looks a lot right now. The big spiny parts and the, all the light reflecting off the color. That's a nice color scheme. I'm happy with that.
Ask your questions.
Identifying stuff! Cryptarch rank 1, they're happy with me! Because I've identified enough stuff, that's an inferior item! Ooh! Knight. So we're going from Totetus type 0 to Knight type 3. Despite not being upgraded, already has higher defense. So our light level is going to go from 129 to 130. There we go. Chest armor did not get a replacement, so let's go ahead and give it more armor. Helm, new one sucks. So let's look into that upgrade. A little more armor. Ooh, so a lot of the new stuff was weapons. Machine gun. Alright. I basically never use machine guns, but I keep one on stock just in case I find a situation useful for one. But that's once again an upgrade for my machine gun. There's so many items over here, it's a little terrifying. Alright. Let's see. Auto rifle. Let's start with that. It's our new auto rifle. No. Hand cannon. My current one. Where's my current hand cannon? I don't even see it. So 117. 115. Get rid of that. Alright, now we're down to Scout. Scout 80, Scout 170, obviously. Get rid of the 80. Pulse rifles, 112, 117, get rid of 112. So many pulse rifles just all up in my business right now, and I'm not really a fan. I could use a little space, frankly. There we go, I believe that's a auto rifle. I have a hard light, I don't think I need a Sindonia. Alright. We should be good to go then. What was this? Was it? Yep, it was 30 solar weapon kills, as I figured. Strange coins, those are handy. On weekends, there's a vendor that shows up that sells certain items on a rotating stock, and only really accepts strange coins.
We found Skolas once. We can do it again. We just need to identify his next target. I bet I know how we can get started. Back to the stars.
It's so weird that there's all that dialogue, but then she says some of it, but then not all of it. it's a weird setup. Kind of wish they would just voice act all of it right at the moment and not do the weird pause. Oh well. At least I can duck for no reason. So that's cool.
Confirming resolution of Gadabal Lake bounty. Package broken in transit.